Plague Tale is amazing. If you haven't played this game yet, you definitely should. It's worthy of the many awards it got. What I like most in the game is the atmosphere. You play in medieval France, and the game depicts the Black Plague in an exaggerated and supernatural manner. Something that hasn't been done before in video games. Rats, the historical cause of the plague, swarm cities and devour people. Here is where the historical accuracy ends though. The game is by no means historically accurate. Rats behave like some sort of intelligent lava. But that's alright, because it favors the gameplay. But before getting into the gameplay, I want to tell you that this is not a historically accurate game. Not even by a long shot. Not even tiny details are accurate. I have a bachelor degree on the Inquisition. And I can tell you that the game gets everything wrong about the church, the clothing, the dialogues. Everything is just wrong when it comes to history. So take the game as fiction. But man, what a fiction it is. And if you play the game, I suggest you to play it with headphones. The music is so good in the game, it sets the mood just right. And it sounds amazing. It's like an orchestra is behind you all the time. The music stops to emphasize moments or gets creepy when it should. And the sounds are so satisfying. Out of all the aspects in the game, the sound design is one that impressed me the most. It was spot on. And the gameplay, wow. You can clearly see that the devs put a lot of effort in it. Every level is unique. You never feel like doing the same stuff twice. Sure, stealth parts are the main part of the game, but they are always something else. Because the more you progress, the more items you get. And you get to use the new items in that level, combine items from previous levels. Even the combat can be considered puzzling. Because usually you have multiple options to take out an enemy. It's not like in other games, mash the button till the enemy is down. No, the combat is strategic. You play as Amicia, a teenage girl, and she doesn't have the force to fight hand in hand with enemy adult soldiers. But she has good aim and a slingshot. Problem is, this is no first person shooter. You don't just point and swarm enemies with rocks. Amicia has to spin the rocks, which means that your attacks take time till you can land a hit. Also, rocks are limited, and so are other items. But don't worry, usually you'll find on the map the items you need to pass a mission. Because the gameplay is leaned more towards storytelling than on gameplay. Sure, you play almost all of the game, this is a video game. But when you play, you'll feel that the game is linear and pushes you towards story progression. And this is great, because the story is amazing. I won't tell you anything from it, because if I would, even a tiny bit of the story, I'll spoil it for you. But just know that the story is unique, engaging, and amazing. It's something you haven't seen before, neither in video games, nor in normal media or books. And I love how the more you progress, the more stuff you get to play with. During gameplay, as I said, the main part is stealth. But there are also puzzles, quick combat parts, chases, and all are super intense and feel unique. When you travel, you have to get as much loot as possible, as loot helps you craft items and get upgrades, and there are also collectibles to be found in the game. Overall, it's amazing. Its story, gameplay, and sound design makes it a unique game that you haven't seen before, and an amazing game you'll want to replay for sure. If you haven't played this one yet, you're missing out big time if you don't play this game.